caravan full of cars, neighborhood stars, up, up, up the boulevard we go till we can't go no more. It's me and mine, it's summertime. You go off and we go on.
As we go on.
I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, a very good defense will be on the field. The Ravens are the least scored on team in the league, and they'll be up against a 49ers offense that will need to rise to the occasion.
Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Inner Harbor and M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the San Francisco 49ers and the Baltimore Ravens. The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. This is Jalen Richard. He'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 23.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
7 yards to go on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 7. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Looking to throw. Now he'll escape to his left. He may try and run for this. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. It's a pickup of 11 at a Baltimore first down.
Now that definitely hurts because the mindset is getting a 3 and out there and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
They'll set up a throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down. Offense still needing 10 yards. 2nd down. They'll set up to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a 3rd down. Nearly lost the football, but kept it after the fumble, but now they face a 3rd down.
All right, here we go.
And he motions the wide receiver. Gun now on 3rd down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for sack. Solomon Thomas in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. So on fourth down, here's Sam Cook to punt it away. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. Taking it about the 16. 45 yards, that's what the punt goes for. 5 on the return. And the Niners will go on offense. First and 10. This is Williams, and the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. And ready now for 2nd and 9. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. They said there was a lot of discussion in their defensive team meeting room after last week's performance. They had 7 sacks. Something in the water. There's one in the first quarter.
A lot of discussion, a lot of excitement, because now everyone wants to get involved with this. Who's going to continue that process? Who's going to get to the quarterback this week? They have to be
careful. It's caught inside the 25. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
Now a play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Defense went 3-4. They got some push from the inside.
And this is something in a 3-4 you don't normally get, because the nose tackle who got the sack, he's usually responsible or ends up getting double teamed and sometimes triple teamed. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground?
Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for 3rd. Now the Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on 3rd down.
Could be a blitzer.
Hurry up, here we go. Back down, yeah, Philly, here we go. Detroit!
From the gun, it's Mahomes. Eluding the pressure right. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up 4th down. A 3rd down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
And that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
Maybe an anxious moment or two when the ball was on its way, but he does find a way to curl it in.
Oh, yeah. That one definitely hugged the left upright, but he got it to go.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number 1 seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number 1 in their conference.
That's good for a Raven first down, 15 yards there. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity. And that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week. And right now, we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons that they're so successful, they know how to mix in the run and make sure that they keep the defense off balance and not able to just simply say, let's go get the quarterback and disrupt things.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. He lost two there, and it's third down.
Okay, let's just make this one simple. We know that the running game is not their thing, but they can't just throw it on every single down without expecting some real heat from the pass rush. And you don't want to get hung up on the word potential, but when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. I'm no offensive mastermind, but of all the guys on the field to block, you might want to stop him.
Look, I've got a very simple rule. An unblocked defender is usually your best defender, and he ended up making the play there.
And he's got the veteran here. It's Mike Wallace. The Raven passing game getting in sync, another first down. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver because you got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone. Sometimes you're throwing it between the zones. Sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the Ravens who have the football. They face a 2nd and 7 to start things out. This go around, he's hit behind the line and taken down. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Count me as a little bit surprised by what we just saw there because this has been a pretty long drive. And normally you think that wears down a defense. In this case, looked like the offensive line let him down a little bit.
Yeah, allowed the penetration and the ability to stuff him for a loss. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for 4th down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get more rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. Work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. There are the 49ers getting set to trot out there. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in, so a lot to fight for.
Yeah, and wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff that they all made sure to let us know. We know where we are right now, but the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together, formulating a streak, got the whole month of December still left to play. They think they can get in.
And they made it very obvious to us that there's no playoff talk in the locker room right now. It's win this game and look to next week.
Excellent focus.
On second down, here's Mahomes. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. First down. Flush to his right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Now we've got whistles and a timeout here. Yeah, it looks like we've got a 49er that's down on the field. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. 4 minutes to play here in quarter number two. And again, it's Mahomes. Steps away to his left. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. This will be fielded at the 17. Might have been one man away from 6 points. As it stands, it's a huge return. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. They go play action here on first down. And he's got some space here. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down. Now a handoff looking right. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
All right, here we go.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And this is caught at the 8. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. Give him 7 yards on the carry, and it will take us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We're back to Baltimore after this. The offense on third down, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. They're looking at a 3rd and goal here.
Green 39.
Oh, how about this call down near the goal line? And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. Rashad Perriman, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Ravens are in for 6. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And San Francisco gets set to go here.
And hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Now Carlos Hyde in the game. And he powers his way up past the 30. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. Mahomes used to moving quickly in college, trying to get his guys to the line. Mahomes to throw on 2nd down. And an alley to run. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 8 yards that time, able to take off, and the result is a 1st down.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was Tuckett in run time, and he picks up a 1st down.
Let's go!
1st down, a run with Hyde. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. A good run there on 1st down, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 2. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Now Mahomes throwing on 2nd down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. The 20, 10, and he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. Make it back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the groove, and what are the odds of what we're seeing right here? You don't see it happen very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season, it's been a big year, let alone back-to-back weeks. Tell you this, I wouldn't play cards against this guy in the locker room.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down. Now here's Mahomes. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
On 3rd and long, it's Mahomes. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. It's just their 1st, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And the punt team on now as this one sent away. That's taking it around the 40. Oh, he slipped right by him. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the 1st half. They'll throw now on the final play. Going long here for Wallace. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. And apparently that's all, Larry. So much for the halftime report. We'll see you in the postgame. We're ready to get to the 3rd quarter. Fielded about 1 yard deep. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20.
Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is a I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. They run again with Hyde on first. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
Give to Hyde, and an alley to run, and he's going to get this inside the 30. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Play action. Now Mahomes going for the deep ball. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Now Mahomes on the bootleg. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment. But here, he's one that has to absorb the contact. And as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
The Niners on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and seven. Now Mahomes. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. And my goodness, this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Ravens are going to get the football back. Well, that's another mistake there on the drop pass on fourth, and we've seen them do things like this all game.
It's not hard to figure out why they're down by that deficit. They haven't made plays that are going to keep them in the game or win the game all game long. That's another example right there. It all boils down at the end of it to execution. Either you make the play or you don't.
Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. And a solid run on first down. Gain of seven leaves him with a second and three.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point. Going to make that defense stand up and stop it. On play action, they'll throw. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. A good chance. This is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at it into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tartt.
Okay, partner,
No surprise to you. I'm going to look at this from the defensive perspective. In the rain, you have to be more cautious trying to cover passing routes. Why? The offense knows where they're going with the football. The receiver knows the route he's going to run. You have to make sure you keep your footing underneath you.
Rolling to his left. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
No, check. Patriot, over. Check.
On second down, Hyde. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Carlos Hyde, see you later. And they do finally get him at the 12. It's a big run there by Hyde. 59 yards on the ground. And now a first down following that long gain. To throw, it's Mahomes. He'll buy some time right. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
Hand off comes to Hyde, and he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. They give him 2 yards there as they're set up now with a 1st and goal. And here we go on 1st and goal. Mahomes now on the sneak. And no signal, but I don't think he got the surge behind center. No, he's going to be kept out of the end zone. No gain there as he kept it himself at 2nd down.
Here we go now. Green, 39. Detroit.
Here's the former Raven fullback, Kyle Juszczyk. And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. Kyle Juszczyk, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the 49ers have cut it back within a score. Out to kick is Janikowski. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And the Ravens taking the field. They've got to right the ship. They had a great first half, but the lead has really gone down. Now, you know, you always talk about the adjustment to the adjustment. They've got to adjust right here.
And I think a lot of it is just mentally. Get back to doing what you were doing well in the beginning of the game, but a lot of that is playing with that emotion and that sense of pride and fire. It sometimes goes away a little bit when you build up a lead. You think you've got it going, and you also think, at any moment I can go ahead and go back to the way it was before. You and I both know it's not that easy once you get off the gas a little.
Yeah, they don't want to see this lead diminish anymore. 12 yards the pick up there, good for a Raven first. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro, Navarro Bowman. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line. This defense figured out something in the locker room. That's 2 third quarter picks now.
And you just wonder, did he get too comfortable in the locker room himself? His team has the lead. Take care of the football. He's putting them in jeopardy right now.
Here we go now. 3-19. Gone. Here we go now. On there. Look at 56.
So after the INT, here's Mahomes. He's going to float this one deep right side. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now, in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me? Can I create a penalty downfield, maybe pick up an interference call and get that yardage downfield? Anything trying to get going again, but you're right, he definitely took a shot.
And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third. The Niners on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Dancing to his left. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. So the D-line's going to spread out. They run high. And all the ball's out. Hyde fumbled it. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
All these years we've been watching the game, I start to get the sense that whenever it rains out, those guys have to touch the ball and carry it. They're extremely resentful about that weather.
Yeah, I'm just happy I'm not resentful that we have a roof over our heads. I know that much.
Yeah, maybe we won't fumble our play sheets here as we just saw the fumble happen on the field.
He's going to air one out. That's caught inside the 20. A big play that time for the Ravens. 55 yards. The last drive he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there's a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw 5 and still find a way to win the game in the end.
He'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 5. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another first down. Oh, how about this on first and goal? Oh, good footwork on the spin. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. So they're on the 5-yard line here, second down and goal. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be knocked down sideways at the 2-yard line. He'll get a couple of yards on the keeper, but it's going to lead to a 4th down.
How about that for defense? Every hole plugged up. Can't run it inside, can't bounce it outside. That sets up 4th and goal from the 2. Right now, advantage defense.
So his 2nd field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make them score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the 4th quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Deep ball for Goodwin. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Mahomes again here on second and 10. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. But not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right, that pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. Flushed out right. And he's got room. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. To get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
It's a gain of 6. Moves him to a manageable 3rd and 2 situation. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down.
Watching that body. Let's go. 3-9. Detroit. Detroit. Hurry up. Here we go.
Mahomes looking to throw on 3rd and 2. Escaping the pressure right. Now it's caught inside the 25. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. And that one results in 35 yards. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10. Play action. Now it's Mahomes. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Tavon Young. And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
Hey, it's another Oski, because that's the word we use when we intercept the pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the Oski, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Second and 10. That's into the hands of Wallace over the middle. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down. The Ravens on third down. 3 for 7 so far in this game. This time it's 3rd and 3.
Let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
He'll look to throw. Looking for his running back and he's got him. And oh, it caught it up! And now this is scooped up by the 49ers.
Partner, that would look like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, 2-score game, so hold on here, not done in the fourth. Fumble recovery. It's Mahomes. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Tyus Bowser with a pick. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily that you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. On first down, Mahomes. Eluding the pressure right. They find some open field here. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. Second down to the offense, needing 5 yards. Mahomes going to throw. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense, because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Mahomes looks to throw on third down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. C.J. Mosley in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. Mahomes and the offense staying out there. They'll go for it on fourth. Got to have this one. Being chased out left. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Tyus Bowser with a pick. And they will take over at the 26-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
And this one goes nowhere, losing yardage back at the 22. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Let's go.
And now here's a carry heading left. And he'll get this one up to the 26. 3 yards on the pickup there, and they've got it back to third and 10. And the 49ers going to take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. The Ravens on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This is third and 10. Got a man over the middle. Complete. Past the 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A big play there. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Ravens will extend their lead. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone can stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going. But it's not just their own confidence that is leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now, because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
That game's gone final now at Heinz Field. And the Steelers coming away victorious there. If they hang on, that would up their win total to 5 on the season so far.
All right, now, look at 56. Let's go. Let's go. Here we go. Leopard.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Now a desperation throw. And my goodness, another interception. picked off by Marlon Humphrey. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran the wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing him.
They'll set up to throw. Flush to his right. Throw right side taken in by Wallace. The Raven passing game getting in sync. Another first down.
Sometimes it's design, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
And this one incomplete. So the clock stopped now with 20 seconds remaining.
After that throw, and it was definitely one that he would love to have back, I wonder what's going through his head. I wonder what kind of mind game he's playing with himself to get himself back on track. Because a lot of guys, that's what they do. They have little triggers that when the mechanics are off or if they make a bad throw, that they go to that place to get themselves back in sync.
And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. That one looks like he'll throw here. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tartt. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other. But it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Oh, wait, hold everything. A timeout has been called. Seemingly silly with 1 second remaining in this game. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. They run it again with Hyde. Stays on his feet.
Go, go! It's run! It's run! They run it!
Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down. Sit like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show 'em how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show 'em how to act. Okay, now picture little Bobby, just a younger, run around with his man's in his hand, feeling like a man. Run, put him, get the, put it to your brain like. Everybody know you ain't about it. Everything you talk about. I know I can live without it. Red light, stop. Green light, go. Everything ain't what it seem like. I know. Hold up, what you mean? Where you been in? This is merely the beginning again. What you been living in? The box under the bridge, like Anthony Kiedis, looking for something to complete us and maybe lead us. A long way from equalists, how they treat us. Body of a builder with the mind of a fetus. Turn on the television and see the vision they feed us. And I wish I could erase that face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love. Everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know. I've been knocking Joe down like a witness. God is my witness, I'm witness, but on the real, I think I need another witness. If it was 17, black daddy, white mama wouldn't change a thing. Light skin, certified as a house. Go figure, in my blood is the thud, been a master. It's like the devil playing space with the pastor. But he was born with the privilege. Man, what the fuck is that? People told me as a child, as a little boy playing with his toys, I should be ashamed. And some people look ashamed when I rap, like my great-granddaddy didn't take a to the back. Not accepted by the pedal. I don't give a fuck, praise God, I can see the light. Everybody talk about race this, race that. I wish I could erase that, face facts. Everybody people. Everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know how it go. Everybody people,
Everybody bleed, everybody need some. Everybody love, everybody know. Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down. Seem like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show them how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show them how to act.
Too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Always hanging on to the visual. I wanna be invisible. Looking at my years like I'm out of dumb. Everybody needs to be a part of them. Never be enough on the prodigal son. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Parenthetical, hypothetical, working out of something that I'm proud of. Out of the box, an epoxy to the world and the vision we've lost. I'm an apostrophe. I'm just a symbol to remind you that there's more to see. I'm just a product of the system of catastrophe. And yet a masterpiece, and yet I'm half diseased. And when I am deceased, at least I go down to the grave and die. Leave the body of my soul to be a part of me. I do what it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Like the way it sounds, Frody?
Yeah. Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe. Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe. It's too hot, drop the top off the wagon. Lay back, fire like dragon. Man, I'm flying past Saturn. Out of here like I ain't that savage.
No.
It's like I'm at the studio with Michael. You can hear me dancing on the beat. Bam, bam, about to put a mansion on the beach. 100 Latins in your lobby. That's what happens when you're around with body. And I put that my mommy. I will never give my heart to a
I could just make a dance that goes with this song. Then I'ma be on. Basic
gonna dance to it. Basics everywhere, gonna dance to it. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute. White Range Rover, let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe for a minute. White Range Rover, ballin' it. You gotta, baby, shake that. Shake that, shake that. You gotta, baby, shake that. Shake that, shake that. I got two shows, I'm about to pitch another. Throwing alley-oops to my brothers. We all shine, nobody victims. I'm on these sweatsuits. Black Pippins, I swag different. That's why the money in the bag different. Come up short, you left your fam. I lay on beaches and swerving whips. You ain't serving, you just an urban myth. Every day, get ride around Queens on a jet ski. It's me. Every day, get to the day I die. Every day, get man, I'm set. And I'm that bouncing up and down. Nearly broke. Nearly broke. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute. White Range Rover, ballin' it. Let me breathe for a minute. Just let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe for a minute. White Range Rover, ballin' it.
Too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest, I got millions on my mind, and you didn't fit the picture, so I guess you want the vibe.
LOV on my right leg, that's Gucci. Dig what I'm saying. LOV on my man, that's Gucci. Dig what I'm saying. Caught a little jet lag, but I'm golden. Yeah. We deserve Grammys and some Oscars. They deserve Whammys, they imposters. I be rolling with my project homies. It's a vibe. I just with the homie. It's a vibe. Over switch sides, it's a vibe. Yeah. I gon' do it. Gon' do it. Gon' do it. I gotta accept that I'm a. Yeah. I pull up in several different options. Yeah. That I but most of them. I shatter your dreams with this cream I make. Cream I make. What? Gotta be on. Gotta be on. The thinker. I say. What? I can't feel my toes, but I ain't gon' fold up. Fold up. I was in the double law when I rolled. When I rolled.
I've been rolling on the freeway. I've been riding 85. I've been thinking way too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest. I got millions on my mind, and you didn't fit the picture, so I guess you want the vibe. I've been rolling on the freeway. I've been riding 85. I've been thinking way too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest. I got millions on my mind, and you didn't fit the picture, so I guess you want the vibe.
Dig what I'm saying, Janelle Drake's on me daily. Dig what I'm saying, sponsored by Mercedes. Dig what I'm saying, this Creek alone is on me, baby. Dig what I'm saying, I'm going hard. Yeah. I pop in your memory. In your memory. You should be glad I'm showing you sympathy. Showing you sympathy. I gave you real love out the gutter. Out the gutter. If I let you go, you gon' suffer. You gon' suffer from it. I gon' do it. Gon' do it. Gon' do it. I gotta accept that I'm a. I pull up in several different options. Yeah. That I but most of them. I shatter your dreams with this cream I make. Cream I make. What? Gotta be on. Gotta be on. The thinker. I say. What? I can't feel my toes, but they gon' fold up. Fold up. I was in the double law when I rolled. When I rolled. When I rolled. Yeah.
I feel like I should be giving up. You can't leave if it's too much. But I'm tired of you, me on. Oh, I don't like where this is going. You know?
Gave my all, but you want it all from me. Keep your love, it doesn't feel the same. I hope it hurts you when you hear my name.
To the float out, you already know though. It's Adamville for real, you see ya. Just take a photo. I'm reppin' as I'm photo with a on your bro though. Bro, that dodo thought that he could rob a player for some dodo. Oh no, also Allen Temple, also England Manor, also Misty Valley. And I got a couple yesterday out of Cali. Am I bad from the valley? Bought me brand new balance. Bet I'm playing with a no American dream. Man, she been riding since her daddy rode on four. I done in every hoe telling every I ain't with my wife, but if she meet her, might be a go.
Rick flap, flash it. Don't I look dashing? Don't I look classy? Don't act so sassy. I'm the man, boo. That's with or without you.
with what your say. Show me what that, what that, what that.
I hear him talking, talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but this the best. Hey, don't you see me out here shining, shining, barely flexing? I hear him talking, talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but this the best. And even if we die today, gon' live forever, live forever.
Daddy Pat say with three X's. No exit on my chest, but all these diamonds got me blessed. Usually I don't do this, dumb it down, go stupid. Since 17 been counting M's, my bank account's on goofy. They say gave up. Now who know what the truth is? Chicago full of, my garage is full of hoop. This got that southern drawl and all that. My like ball bass. So I've got something to say, and all y'all can't get y'all ball back. If I ain't a hot boy, then what do you call sacks? Daddy fat, y'all never ball back. Like clocks in the wintertime, we stay eating like it's dinner time. Been feasting and feasting and feasting big, but it ain't no rhyme. We don't know the meaning of drought, cause we keep it so wet, why swear not? It's been a while. Just speaking in general, why there is no formidable opponent or at that bone that you never step on it. When you wanna mind the kind of giving hope, hope when they down and out. Dig a hole so deep, ain't no climbing out.
I hear him talking, talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but this the best. Don't you see me out here shining, shining, barely flexing? I hear him talking, talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but this the best. And even if we die today, gon' live forever, live forever.
Yo, yo, listen, listen. Just like I told Coco, my vision is vision. You already know though, know so go, slow, bang, my logo, for show, sure, go,
get down on the,
Yo, yo, listen, listen. Just like I told Coco, my vision is vision. You already know though, know so go, slow, bang, my logo, for show, sure, Coco, can I get down, on the.
Let the spirit flow.
I know you ain't there yet. Don't stop to catch your breath.
Yeah, you know. Let it be. Halo on me, Saint LeBron.